95, whack-a-mole number 95, snowstorm edition. A lot of people don't know it snows in Seattle, not very often. I think we had like a half a day last year. 2 years ago, we had 4 days. But in the 7 years I've been here, I think I've had, this is the third major storm. So I hope you got a little new information about the weather patterns in Seattle. It's not just rain all the time, but it's not anything like the Midwest or East Coast snowstorms usually, but it's really beautiful out. So, whack-a-mole number 95, five random record picks. Let's do it. One. Two. Three. Four, five. On the Road to Freedom, Alvin Lee and Mylon LaFerve, Columbia Records, about 1976, I guess. 73, I'm way off. The great Alvin Lee, you probably know, guitar player from 10 Years After. And there's a Beatle connection on this one because, as I recall, George Harrison's song So Sad is on here, and Harry Georgeson plays guitar on it under the name Harry Georgeson, which, if you can't figure that out, you're not cool. This is an okay album. It's a milder album. It's almost singer-songwriter-ish. Rock album, but not heavy rock. There's some nice lead guitar players playing on it. Mylon LaFerve does most of the vocals on this, as I recall. And there you go. It wasn't the hit that they expected it to be, I'll put it that way. But it's a nice record. Ah. This is a singer I should have included in my recent soul record collection video. Some of my favorite soul records, soul artists. Incredible. This is a great comp too. This is a Columbia Brunswick from the 70s comp of Jackie Wilson. What a great soul pop singer from the 60s and 70s, starting in the late 50s. You know, he was a contemporary of James Brown and Sam Cooke. Really great record. Reet Petite was the sort of the big song that I remember getting into. And of course, Van Morrison has a great song called Jackie Wilson's Said that opens up his St. Dominic's preview. Jackie Wilson said it was Reet Petite. God, Lonely Teardrops, a Berry Gordy song. Oh, God. I forgot how great this is. I mean, I didn't forget. I just haven't, he hasn't been on my mind lately, but highly recommended. I think everyone in their specimen collection of great records needs a Jackie Wilson. This is the Jackie Wilson story. A record I show way too often, but you know, out of all these 5,000 plus records or 6,000 records, The Birds, Sweetheart of the Rodeo. This, I believe, is an original. Oh no, this is a 70s issue. Oh, this is a copy I picked up. This is funny. This is really interesting. I picked this up at a used record store. I do have another copy of it. And this is a, I'd say, 72, 73 pressing. But look what was inside it. So, somebody traced the cover. Don't you love occasionally finding, you know, mildewy, smelly papers inside a record? I think I need a new, I gotta right now go change, put the MoFi sleeve, it's kind of yellowing. But of course, the Great Birds record, possibly the first country rock record, along with Bo Brummel's Bradley's Barn, which came out the same year. Graham Parsons on this, but Graham Parsons' lead vocals were stripped off or not used, and Roger McGuinn's vocals were used until the CD reissue and the record store day issue of this. That has both versions, the songs that Graham Parsons sings lead on. Of course, the Leuven Brothers I got turned on to because of this record, and Graham Parsons brought that type of music to hear. But what a great record. Also, Graham Parsons is on here, Roger McGuinn, Chris Hillman, you know, from the original Byrds, obviously, and Clarence White, the great guitar player, sort of starts on here before he becomes a full-fledged member of the Byrds. Songs for a Blue Guitar, the Red House Painters, Mark Kozelek's project, one of his projects, along with Sun Kill Moon, and there's another one that's escaping me. I remember getting this on CD originally, and I had it for maybe 6 months, and I would play it a lot. I really didn't look at the titles of the songs, or, you know, the CD period wasn't a time like when I was growing up where I'd read every liner note, who was on it, who designed it, as often as I did when records on vinyl came out. 6 months, I remember this now, I remember the moment I had the CD playing one day, and again, I'd heard it so many times before that, and all of a sudden I realized one of the songs here was a cover song. It was Silly Love Songs. I had heard that song maybe 8-9 times on this record, just as I was doing things playing the CD, and it's a really slow, long, dirgy version of Paul McCartney's Silly Love Songs, the Wings record from Wings at the Speed of Sound, and it's a really cool version of it. I think it goes on for maybe 6-7 minutes before any lyrics, and he sings it so slow it's almost unrecognizable, but it is a really cool version of it. I'm so happy to have this record. Beautiful design, love it. This was originally on 4AD, as I recall. And of course, you know, maybe I didn't have a lot of variety this time. Going back to what I consider one of the best Fleetwood Mac records, then play on. Of course, those of you who love the song Oh Well, which was a single split over A and B sides, a long version, was not on the original pressing list and was added later in the US. But what a gorgeous cover on here. I love this painting. The Peter Green, this is the last record Peter Green on. Of course, it has Oh Well on here, Rattlesnake Shake, incredible record. And of course, this has, okay, let's see, Peter Green, Jeremy Spencer, and Danny Kirwan. So the three great guitar players of Fleetwood Mac all on this record. Really, this is a transition, and it's an incredible, incredible record. Let's just pull one more. It's a snow day. I really can't go out. I'm not going to go shoveling snow now. It's almost cocktail time. So one more random pick, and I think I'll pick this from the jazz section, which is right to my right here. Nothing like playing a like cool jazz record on a snowy day. Blue Note 80 record, Pete LaRocca, Basra. So it's a drummer-based record, very percussive, very Latin-based. Joe Henderson's on sax, Steve Kuhn on piano, and Steve Swallow on bass. This is a cool record. It's half the songs are originals by Pete LaRocca, but again, it's a very percussive record and a fun record and really nice. Of course, these are great. Kevin Gray cuts for Blue Note. I'm gonna pick one more because I've been showing so many fucking Tone Poet and Blue Note. I'm getting sick and tired of all this highfalutin audiophile Blue Note crap. So let's go deeper a little, I'm gonna go lower, but I'm gonna not look again. Comp. This is a 70s reissue on Columbia Records. This is Monk, Thelonious Monk live at the Jazz Workshop. These are older recordings. I think when this came out, most of these recordings hadn't been reissued at the time. Thelonious Monk, Charlie Rouse on tenor sax, Larry Gales on acoustic bass, and Ben Riley on drums. This is produced by the great Teo Maceo, who did a lot of work for Columbia. Obviously, a lot of the Miles Davis stuff. he did and edited really well and worked it really well. The connection to me is this is recording live at the Jazz Workshop in San Francisco. Thelonious Monk is one jazz artist I never saw in person, unfortunately, but this is from 1964 anyway, so I would have been a 10-year-old kid. It's probably a 21 and older club, as I recall. And there you go. The great Thelonious Monk from San Francisco, 1984. Read the liner notes to know more about this record. Mazzy loves you, and keep warm wherever you are. Keep safe, and let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Mazzy loves you.
The beat goes on. The beat goes on.